Hi, I'm Sajid Sanonik from whoisthewebsite.com. Today I will show you how to move a WordPress website from one domain to another domain using a WordPress plugin called Wall in on WP Migration plugin.
Today I will show you how to move WordPress website from one domain to another domain. I will use All in One Migration plugin, and you don't need any cPanel access for this. So what will you need? You need login access of two WordPress website. Today I will transfer webbuildersbd.net to onic.work. So this is a fresh WordPress installation, and this is another WordPress installation having a lot of content. So this website will be transferred to this domain. So let's get it started. Firstly, you need to log in to webbuildersbd.net. I already logged in. You have to log into this website using having your access. After that, you need to go plugins and add new plugins. After going add new plugins, you have to search for All in One WP Migration. Here is the plugin, actually All in One Migration plugin. I am installing this. After installing, I will activate this plugin. So the plugin is now activated. Then we need to go this option, All in One WP Migration. I am going on into this. The plugin have actually some premium features. There are many extensions, like you can send the backup file to Dropbox or Drive and can restore it. It will help you to restore the file without downloading. I already bought the Dropbox extension so that I can transfer the file without downloading. Here is the option, actually Dropbox, Google Drive. I will use it Dropbox, but I will show you the free way also. So how to export the files, so export the all files having no premium features. Please click on file and it will start to export everything in a folder. After that, something will appears. You need to click on that and download the file on your local disk. Here is the file. If I click on this, it will start downloads. Let's click. Yes, it starts downloading. Please download this and save it into your local disk. But I will use the Dropbox extension. It will backup the file in Dropbox. Let's install the Dropbox extension also. Here is the Dropbox extension. Install it. This extension is bought by myself few days ago. It is maybe $99. You can use it for unlimited website. So here we go. So now we can export the file into our Dropbox. Export to Dropbox. Link to your Dropbox account. You need to log into your Dropbox account using this API. So I will do that. I logged into Dropbox and it is now connected. So let's export the files, all the backup of this webbuildersbd.net. I clicked on export and the page. So now I am clicking on Dropbox and it is starting to back up all of the file in our Dropbox. We need 1 or 2 minutes to transfer the file. So I am pausing the video in this meantime. It's 20%. We need to wait for another 1 minute. So here we go. It's already uploaded to Dropbox. So what we need to do now? Now we need to log into our another WordPress website where we would like to restore this webbuildersbd.net website. Now we need to install the two plugins again. So this is the website where we would like to restore the webbuildersbd.net. We need to log into the WordPress. We are installing the two plugins again, all in one WP migration and the Dropbox extension. Let's search for all in one WP migration. I installed it and activated it. Now again installed the Dropbox extension. Let's activate it. Now go to all in one WP migration and it will be the option import. So if you don't have Dropbox extension, you need to upload the file that you downloaded before. So what you need to use this option, fill file, and find the location you saved and click on it and upload it, and that's it. What I will do, use the Dropbox option. Let's click on it and let's link our account again. Now import. So now click on Dropbox and it will show the list of backup you backed up before. So I will choose the webbuildersbd.net, this option, and click again and import. Same thing you need to do when upload the file from your local disk. So it will start to upload the file from Dropbox, and let's wait for 1 minute. Here we go. We need to proceed the option. Let's proceed it. It will restore the database file into your database, and after restoring the file, it will be overwritten by webbuildersbd.net files. Even the username and password also. You can log in by using previous login access of your own of your onic.org domain rather than using the login access of webbuildersbd.net. So firstly, you need to save the permalink. Let's click on it. Here is onic.org, but you can't log in using the username of onic.org previously you used. You need to use the login details of the another website, I mean the website you backed up. I am logging into this and choose the post name option and save changes. So that's it. So let's have a look. Go to visit the site and it is onic.org, and it is completely the same website we saw on the webbuildersbd.net. So I think it will help you to back up your website, to transfer your website from one domain to another domain. If you like our video, please subscribe our channel and stay tuned. Thank you very much.